Our latest drought report out today, and I know a lot of us probably hope to see some improvement on that, but we just have not done it yet. We've had several rainfalls now, but pretty low amounts overall, so we're still stuck in this exceptional drought across pretty much all of central and southern Louisiana. We do have gate-to-gate shear of 125 miles per hour, so there is a good possibility the storm here is producing a tornado. If it's not yet, it could touch down at any time with a very strong radar signature and a very strong radar indicated rotation. We really just obliterated all records this month. We had 27 of our 31 days above 100 degrees. This was at the Alexander International Airport site. Some areas could have been warmer, a little cooler, and only 4 days there in the 90s, and that was the mid and upper 90s. And then not once, but twice, we set an all-time record high temperature of any month of the year of 110 degrees.
You know, Rachel does. She's already in her fall color. So.
That's right. Dress for the weather you want,
that's
not the weather you have.
That is the best advice I've ever heard.
You can see a pretty well-defined hook echo on the radar there, and this is going to be near the intersection of Louisiana Highway 191 and Louisiana Highway 6. This is moving to the northeast, and we are looking at a thunderstorm here capable of producing a tornado. Likely just going to be an area of low pressure that's not quite tropical, as it is going to kind of merge with the frontal system here in the Gulf, but this is headed our way. It's going to take the northeasterly trajectory across southeast Louisiana and towards the Gulf Coast here over the next couple of days. And of course, this is going to be a big rainmaker here. No, Brooke, it's hotter than a blister bug in a pepper patch today.
I'm at a loss.
Okay, wait, we had a couple other good
we
ones.
We did get some good ones.
We asked people on Facebook. Can't read 95% of them. Matt said hotter than a tinfoil sweater.
Okay, that sounds miserable.
That was a good one. And then Sarah said, hotter than 2 mice trapped in a Walmart sack under the floorboard of an abandoned church. If you are in DuPont or Simsport, certainly want to take cover here. Don't travel in the next few minutes. You want to stay away from those exterior walls. Go to the most interior room of your house, away from windows and doors if you can. There's many possibilities here. The closer that ship gets to the bottom there, the better idea you have of where it's going to go. So that's what our forecast looks like. The farther out we are from the forecast, the more options there are. It all depends on what the models do, and there's a lot of different tracks. Nothing else in the tropics for now, but as we head into August, that is one of our busiest months of the year. Typically, we see most of our systems this time of the year form from those easterly waves that develop from that West African monsoon, and sometimes they move up the East Coast over to Florida or into the Gulf of Mexico. So we're likely seeing 2-inch hail in Avoyelles Parish with this storm, and now we have the potential as well for a tornado. So that area of rotation is going to be right on top of Cottonport, but if you're in Mansour, I would use caution as well. As far as the heat, it's hotter than a billy goat with a blowtorch. Then we started noticing that the sea surface temperatures close to the coast were just prime for Laura to strengthen. They were really warm. We realized that wind shear was going to be really low as Laura approached, and sometimes at the last minute you get that rapid intensification of storms. So we've seen that happen before, and that's when we started realizing, really on like late Tuesday into Wednesday, we started realizing that Laura was probably going to undergo rapid intensification. This was part of the church, and you can see there's a nail sticking out from this board. These are pieces of the church, pieces of buildings here that become flying debris, flying objects. Of course, something like this with a nail sticking out of it could certainly become deadly during these tornadoes. So here's how you can tell if you're seeing sleet or snow at your house, which is what a lot of Sinlaw is seeing. This little snowball at the last break, it's actually more of a sleet ball because that's what we have. It is just hard as a rock here. It comes apart a little bit, but it's actually little tiny pieces of ice. That's the difference between sleet and snow. The snow, of course, nice and fluffy. It's nice and quiet when it's falling, but it sounds like it's raining out here. And it's thundering pretty good here, and lightning as well. Some of these smaller ones, it's just turned to nothing but ice out here. So it's just really hard. And this is, of course, that sleet that packed down, and even big chunks of ice here that are really just stuck to just about everything. So those smaller side roads, definitely going to be an issue. And of course, what we're waiting on now is with winter storm number 2, that wintry precipitation to return to central Louisiana here in the next few hours. They're in the tropics. this afternoon. We still have Tropical Storm Philippe. I think we've been talking about this storm for close to 3 weeks now, and we still have about another week to go. It is still down kind of in the Atlantic or Northern Caribbean area north of Puerto Rico. And in the coming days, that is forecast to continue pushing north, and that will likely become an extra tropical cyclone by the weekend. And it is expected to bring stormy conditions now to either Maine or Nova Scotia, somewhere in that general vicinity. And then Philippe should finally be out of our hair. And by the way, a big question is, will this be our last 90 degree day? I know probably all of us are, or at least a lot of us, hoping that is the case. I know we do have some warm weather lovers out there, but last year we did have our last 90 degree day on October 15th. The year before it was in late October. Back in 2020, it was actually in September, believe it or not. And then before that, it was in October. So today we did make it into the 90s. I'm not seeing any sign of any 90s just yet. We are going to warm up and rebound behind our incoming cold front, but it could possibly be our last 90 degree temperature of the year. So we'll be keeping an eye on that. Meanwhile, our cold front is back off to the north and west. That is going to be headed in here tomorrow. We do have some showers and storms to our north, and you probably noticed some hazy skies today, and that's due to some wildfire smoke north of the Great Lakes in Canada, and then we have our high pressure here. So with those clockwise winds around that high pressure, it's brought the smoke down the eastern seaboard and into the southeast. And then, of course, we do have some local wildfires ongoing as well, so that haze could stick around here into tomorrow. We are looking at pretty good rain chances Thursday through Friday morning. A lot of us could see up to an inch with some peak amounts in that 1 to 2 inch range, especially to the north and to the west. So definitely some much needed rainfall. Won't be enough to bust our drought, unfortunately, but it will help with those conditions. So planning it for your Thursday, we could see rain swinging into Louisiana as early as about 5 or 6 a.m. and it will be making its way across the state there. So for most of central Louisiana, we can expect that rainfall to start by mid morning or so and continue into the afternoon hours. And then we'll see the bulk of that rainfall start to push out by Thursday night, but we are going to still keep a chance for some scattered showers around here into Friday as well. And that's because the cooler and drier air is really not going to be arriving here until late Friday, early Saturday morning. And that's when we'll start to get the cloud cover and the rest of the rain out of here. So upper 60s to low 70s for tonight. Highs tomorrow returning to the 80s. So still will be warm, still above average for most of us, with low to mid 80s, some upper 80s here in the metro area. And then after that, we cool down even more behind our cold front. So planning it for your Thursday, definitely might want to keep the umbrella or the raincoat handy tomorrow. Could see some fog tomorrow morning as well, and then scattered showers and thunderstorms. Winds will shift to the north, but not until tomorrow evening. And look at our extended forecast. We'll have that chance for some spotty showers early on Friday as well. Things should be mostly dry by the time Friday night football rolls around, but we still could have some cloud cover hanging out then. But then Saturday morning, we have upper 50s, highs in the 70s, very windy conditions for Friday evening, and especially on Saturday, with northerly wind gusts up to about 25 miles per hour. And then Sunday morning, upper 40s, that is going to be feeling great. The coolest temperatures we have seen in months since about last April, and then highs on Sunday in the 70s. We have 40s again for Monday morning. After that, we do see a gradual warming trend with highs returning to the upper 80s here through the middle of next week.
To me, it's all green flags. You have good weather, lower temperatures, but also some much needed rain coming tomorrow as well.
Much needed rain. It doesn't look like the system will be too strong, so not expecting much in the way of severe weather. So yeah, this is probably the best news I've delivered in a long time.
Look, I'm here for it. Let's keep it coming. Thank you, Rachel.